Our fellow here is talking about the Sixth Assessment Report, and it was called an abstract concluded as the Atlas of Human Suffering. Sino na po nakakinig doon? Pakitaas ang kamay. Atlas of Human Suffering. Okay, pakigoogle po. Karinawa, hindi kayo makatulog mamaya gabi. Atlas of Human Suffering speaks of by 2050, the problem that we have in a global 11 years ago, wherein in a period of 1 hour, more than 5,000 Filipino perish because of Typhoon Haiyan. By 2050, the same strong typhoon will be a yearly occurrence for the Philippines. And we congratulate our country because we're Grand Slam. Three years in a row, we're considered to be the most vulnerable country. So far as the climate abnormalities, we call it the buffet of calamities, strikes our country. And by 2050, there will be famine. There will be a lot of climate migrations. As of now, we have more than 10 million Filipinos. We call them OFW. But for climate events, we call them climate migrants. To laymanize it, dahil narito yung ating mga kasama sa media, wala namang mag-aasawa na kapag tapos mong kinasal, gusto mong magpunta ng abroad. OFW is something personal to me dahil anak pa ako ng OFW. 10 years ang tatay ko, so 10 taon akong, 10 beses akong umiyak sa airport dahil aalis ang tatay ko. And millions of Filipino children having the same kind of tears looking for their father or mother, especially during their birthday, Christmas, etc. Climate change really is more than the economic impact. We have the social impact, of course, the family impact. And that is why today I congratulate the European Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines, because as we speak now, you're touching the life of more than 10 million OFW. You're touching the life of more than 5,000 victims, family victims of Haiyan. And yearly, we have a staggering amount of more than 60 billion pesos, around 66 billion pesos losses due to climate change. And all of these are considered to be part of climate abnormalities. But having identified all of this problem, let us also identify the solution. The solution really is, as provided by Madam, we are talking about ecosystem. It's a whole of humanity, whole of global approach, and here you are, a whole of industry approach. I know I have a video presentations after this. In the video presentation, we're talking about the SDG number 12. One author speaks about we will be dictating the future of the life in the planet the way we consume products and services. And that is why we're advocating sustainable consumptions of products and services. The question is, do we have information which products or services are considered to be sustainable? Do we have the necessary carbon calculator for us to be able to calculate as you purchase real time? We're looking forward to finish this kind of program, and we're talking to young IT professional. Most of them are our fellow Filipino, and most of them are young achievers who would like to give an incubate part to complete such kind of program. It's a program calculator. It's a carbon accounting system. It's a system wherein when you purchase, it's a guilt-free. Guilt-free. Consumer empowerment. You ask me why? Why? Because as of now, as we speak, the power of consumption is the best way for us to dictate the future of the planet. But consumption is being influenced more by advertising. And we have what we call greenwashing insofar as advertising is concerned. And sometimes even the government falls short insofar as greenwashing is concerned. That is why we have a problem like we have the e-jeepney modernization. We have. We binigyan tayo ng uniform coming from other countries telling us that this is a clean, modern vehicle. But insofar as climate change is concerned, as far as you're using fossil-based vehicle, it's not clean vehicle. Even if you are using e-vehicle, if the source of electricity where you plug in your e-vehicle is not coming from a microgrid, coming from solar, but it is coming instead from coal power base or diesel engine, then even you're using e-vehicle, it's not considered to be clean vehicle. There you have what I was talking about, a whole ecosystem, a whole paradigm shift. That is why, as we race to zero, supposed to be within the race, we need to also teach see to it that no one is left behind. Even if company A, company B will win the race to zero, if company C, D, E will be left behind, then we don't have total ecosystem. We don't have total equilibrium. Net zero by 2050, then will not be in reality. However, if that ecosystem that we are campaigning will be fully empowered, fully informed, as we very well know, information is power, then everybody from the AITA there in Pampanga, Central Luzon, to our Marinao there in the southern Philippines will be able to have net zero by 2050. But I